Howdy, 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 my friends. Once again, George Rodriguez, El Conservador, talking to you on KLUP 930 AM radio, The Answer. And we've got our good friend, Mr. Chris Hajec, who is with the Immigration Reform Law Institute in beautiful D.C. And I wanted to get him on here because, of course, we've been talking about the past few days, we've been talking a lot about the issue of what happens if there is a change in the administration and what happens if there is a Biden-Harris administration. Chris, if that happened, what would happen? What would be some of the ramifications, the legal ramifications to immigration law? What might be reversed? What might be pushed forward?
Yes, I'm happy to answer hypothetical questions. If Biden were to become president, and I'm not at all saying that he will.
Yeah, no, we're very hypothetical on it.
it doesn't look like it's going to work for him, but the media is in the full court press, you know, trying to help him and create this illusion that he's inevitable. There's a lot going on there, but if he were to be president, he would. Now we have to keep in mind that the Senate, I suppose, would still be in Republican hands, and the Supreme Court would be as it currently is, the 6-3 Republican appointed majority. Some of the things he would want to do, like have a mass amnesty of all illegal aliens, might be stopped in the Senate, unless he could get deals with enough bad Republican senators. But still, I think that would have to get enough votes to stop a filibuster. And just as in 2007, it might not happen. That might be stopped. He's pledged to do another DACA program, but that's already under legal fire in Texas, where Texas and other states have sued to end DACA, and the court's getting ready to rule there right now, and that decision, which would be against DACA, striking it down, would be upheld by the Fifth Circuit, and then that would be upheld by the Supreme Court, I think. So he can't do DACA on his own the way Obama did. So that wouldn't work. Where he would really be able to do a lot of damage is in reversing Trump's asylum policy and other immigration policies that he's enacted through regulation and that have been very effective, and we've been defending them in the courts. For example, Trump has a wait in Mexico asylum policy, where if you're caught at the border and you claim asylum, you're not released into the United States to await your asylum hearing, and then, of course, they never show up to those hearings. You have to go and wait in Mexico. And they do. They go and wait in Mexico. At least we have an address for them in a lot of these cases. But they still don't show up for their hearings because they know they're going to lose their hearing. And the whole purpose of it was not to have a hearing and achieve asylum, but just to be released into the United States and become an illegal alien. And he will reverse that and bring back catch and release. And that'll just cause a flood to the border of bogus asylum claimants, you know, taking this route into the United States. That would be a disaster. He could do it. It would take some time to reverse the policy, but and there might be legal challenges to it, but it's hard to get standing to challenge a policy like it's easy for the asylum claimants to have standing to get into court, but it's hard for a U.S. citizen to have standing to say, I'm going to be harmed by this specifically, so I have to go to court to try to stop it.
Well,
it would be tough to. But another example is a public charge rule, which Trump enacted, echoing the statute passed by Congress that says we should not give green cards to people likely to be on public assistance, likely to be dependent on public assistance. And of course, they challenged that, but it's in place, and it will be upheld by the Supreme Court eventually. And Biden would reverse that and go back to the older policy started in the Clinton administration of allowing people to get all kinds of public assistance to get green card. And so he would do a lot of damage. Basically, the biggest thing that would happen early is a border surge and a breakdown of the border, where all those caravans and everything would just happen again, and this time they'd get in.
So many of us that live down, you know, along the border, so many of us that, you know, have seen the damage that was done, during the during the Obama administration, to communities that were overwhelmed by unaccompanied minors and by asylum seekers, et cetera, et cetera. You know, we're on pins and needles. I mean, I'll be honest with you. A lot of people are on pins and needles over what could happen.
Yeah, very frightening. I mean, it's a lot of those unaccompanied minors were gang members. I mean, and they would claim that they were fleeing the gang. That's why they had the tattoos, I guess, because they were used to be in the gang, but they quit the gang, and now the gang's after them. And that's how they got in. That's how. And we're gonna have more of that kind of crime. And I mean, yeah, it's got to be a frightening thing. And it's interesting that so many of those counties voted for Trump.
Yeah, it's we keep seeing. We keep hearing the issue of local communities being pressed to defund the police, while at the same time, they want to defund ICE, and they want to release all of these aliens that are under detention. They want to establish sanctuary communities across the country, or if not the whole country, make it a sanctuary community. This is very frightening in many ways.
Yes, it is. It would be total sanctuary. Defunding ICE would require, Congress, but, they have a budget, and they would negotiate about the budget. I don't think ICE funding would be eliminated, but it would not go up much, or it would go down. In the thing that would be eventually agreed on. And then we'd just be overwhelmed with even more numbers and be unable to get any headway on it. And it would just, and of course, the Biden administration would take no steps against sanctuary cities. It's possible that the Supreme Court could take care of that despite Biden and outlaw sanctuary cities. But when you, if you bring back catch and release and have this flood, you're not going to be able to do much, enough enforcement to reverse it.
Yeah.
The way Mexico is going to be over, they'd be waiting in the United States.
It's very, it is very, very disconcerting at this point as to the damage and what could be going to, for the first time we seem to have had, this is, in my opinion, why he got such a big support from Hispanics along the border in Texas, was because for the first time we had somebody who forced Mexico to respect the border. And now we're gonna reverse it, going the complete opposite direction with a possible Harris-Biden administration. I don't know.
People didn't vote for that, and that's not popular outside of real leftists. But it used to be that it was even Democrats like Hillary Clinton and Biden would vote for a wall, and they'd say we have to solve the problem of illegal immigration, nevertheless, stealthily, with the help of Republicans like President Bush, the laws were neglected, they weren't enforced, and the problem just grew bigger and bigger, so it's very hard to reverse it. And with Biden, it would just get even worse.
Yeah, it's...
If they're going to rig elections, how do you do anything about it?
Exactly. Chris, tell the folks how they can follow and how they can donate to Immigration Reform Law Institute.
You can go to our website, IRLI, that's early, IRLI, Immigration Reform Law Institute, conservatorshow.org.
Gotcha. And we've been talking, my friends, with Mr. Chris Hyatt with the Immigration Reform Law Institute. Chris, thank you very, very much for being on our show and giving us some insight on the legal situation. Hopefully, things will not reach that point, but you know, it's good to know what might happen.
Yes, I'm happy to be here.
Got it. Have a good one. Once again, George Rodriguez, El Conservador on KLUP 930 AM Radio, The Answer.